Hello everyone, let us continue our discussion on set theory. In that next problem, if set A equal to x such that x is a natural number. X is a natural number. Set B equal to x such that x is a even natural number. First set x such that x is a natural number. Set B x such that x is an even natural number. An even natural number. Comma, find A intersection B and A union B. In this case, they have given sets in set builder form. First, we should write its roster form. Then evaluate A intersection B and A union B. Set A, x such that x is a natural number. Write all the natural numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Clearly it is an infinite set. Set A is an infinite set. Then what about B? Set B equal to x such that x is an even natural number. Write all the even natural numbers. That is 2, 4, 6 and so on. Clearly it is also an infinite set. Set B is also infinite because there exist infinite number of even natural numbers. Right? Now, first one, A intersection B, set A 1, 2, 3 and so on, intersection, set B 2, 4, 6 and so on. Now, what is all A intersection B? A intersection B means common elements of A and B. Common elements of set A and set B is nothing but intersection. First set is all natural numbers. Second set is even natural numbers. What are the common elements? All even natural numbers. In this, in set A, in first set all even and odd natural numbers are there. But in second set only even natural numbers are there. Common is even natural numbers. 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. Or else you can write set B itself. Intersection of these two sets is set B. Second one, A union B. A union B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Union 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. What is A union B? A union B means set of all those elements in A or in B or in both sets. So union of these two sets is clearly 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. It gives union of these two sets. Gives all natural numbers, or else we can write as set A. If you take union of these two sets, it gives set A. If you take intersection, it gives set B. Not necessarily A and B. Just write. In this case, we get B. In this case, we get A. In all the cases, it is not same. In all the cases, intersection need not to be equal to B and union need not to be equal to A. In this case, it happens. Next problem. If A equal to, A means set A equal to X such that X is a natural number, X is a natural number. Set A equal to all natural numbers and set B equal to X such that X is an odd natural number. Set A is equal to all natural numbers, set B is equal to all odd natural numbers. Same as previous one. First we have given sets in roster form. Set A in roster form. X is a natural number means take all the natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. In this case set B is equal to set B is X is an odd natural number. Odd 1, 3, 5, 7 and so on. After that take their intersection. Now A intersection B equal to. A intersection B is equal to replace set A 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Intersection B 1, 3, 5 and so on. Intersection means common elements for both the sets. What are the common elements? Odd natural numbers are common. This is our A intersection B. If set A equal to X such that X belongs to natural number and X greater than or equal to 2 and less than or equal to 6. Set B equal to X such that X square minus 10X plus 21 equal to 0. Find A intersection B and A union B. Both the sets are given in set builder form. Set A is in set builder form and set B is also set builder form. First we need to write its roster form. After writing roster form, find A intersection B and A union B. set A equal to x such that x should be a natural number. There are two conditions. One of the condition is x should be a natural number and it should be greater than or equal to 2 and less than or equal to 6. 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This is our set A. Set A in roster form. Why? Because they are given in set builder form. Before writing their union and intersection, first write the given sets in roster form. After writing roster form, then write its intersection and union. Then set B is nothing but roots of this quadratic equation. We need to write set B in roster form. For that, just solve given quadratic equation. It is our set B. Set B is nothing but roots of this quadratic equation. Product of two numbers should be equal to 21 and their sum or difference should be equal to minus 10. Those numbers are minus 7 and minus 3. If you multiply these two numbers, clearly we get 21. If you add these two numbers, clearly we get minus 10. So on factorization, directly I will write x minus 3 into x minus 7 is equal to 0. After factorization, you get these two factors. Lastly, x equal to 3 or x equal to 7. Therefore, set B is equal to, what is our set B? 3 comma 7. Or else you can write 7 comma 3 also. Because order of the element is immaterial. You can write 3 comma 7 and 7 comma 3, both are 196. Now we need to write A intersection B. A intersection B is equal to, first we place set A. What is our set A? That is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Intersection 3, 7 means 3 comma 7. That's equal to. Intersection means common elements for given two sets. What is common element in these two sets? Element or elements. Only one element is in common. That is 3. Intersection is clearly singleton set. That is 3. A intersection B is 3. Now, after this, write A union B. A union B is equal to, simply replace set A and set B. 2, 4, 6, 2, 3, 2 comma, 3 comma, 4 comma, 5 comma, 6, union set B, that is 3 comma, 7. What is definition of union of sets? Union of sets means write all those elements in A or in B. Write common elements once. That's equal. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. This is our A union B. Next problem, if set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, set B is equal to 3, 5, 7, 8. Find A union B. Clearly say roster form. Clearly roster form is given. A union B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 union 3, 5, 7, 8. After that, A union B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Write all those elements in A, R in B, R in both the sets. 5. After 5, then 7 and 8. This is our A union B. Next problem. Next problem. If A equal to, means that A equal to 3, 4, 5, and 6, set B equal to 5, 6, 7, 8. Set C equal to 4, 6, 8. Verify that A union of B union C equal to A union B union C. And second one, A intersection of B intersection C is equal to A intersection B intersection C. They have given three sets in roster form. We need to verify A union B, A union of B union C equal to A union B union C. And second one, A intersection of B union, sorry, B intersection C equal to A intersection B intersection C. It is associative law in union, associative law in intersection. First one, in that we need to find B union C first. First find LHS part. In that B union C, because we need B union C, that's equal. B union C, I will write directly, write B union C. Or else you can replace set B and set C, then write B union C. But I will write directly. B union C 4, 5, or else write all those elements in B and in C. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is our B union C. 5, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8. Then 4, there, 8, comma. This is our B union C. After that, what is our LHS part? After that, we need B union, A union B also. For verifying this, we need B union C value and A union B value. After that, write A union B. What is A union B? That is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can write directly A union B and B union C. A union B is 3, 4, 5, 6. 5 and 6 come 7, 8. This is our A union. After that, find LHS of first one. What is our LHS? A union of B union C. That's equal to set A, that is 3, 4, 5, 6, union. Already we have B union C value. Directly replace B union C. B union C is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. After that, take union of these two sets. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Take this as equation number 1, and this is our LHS. After that, find RHS part. What is our RHS part? RHS is equal to, consider RHS part of first one. What is RHS part? A union B union C. That's equal. Already we have A union B value. This is our A union B. Replace A union B. What is A union B? This is 3, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is our A union B. Write union symbol. Union. C. Already we have set C. That is 4, 5, 5, 4, 6, 8. That's equal to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Take this as equation number 2. Now look at 1 and 2. Equation number 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 4, RHS also 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From 1 and 2. From equation number 1 and 2, what do we conclude? Clearly 1 equal to 2. 1 equal to 2 means A union of B union C equal to A union B union C. Clearly from 1 and 2 we conclude A union of B union C equal to A union B union C. This is first. In that second part, what is second question? Verify associative property for intersection. What is second part? This is our second part. For verifying second part, what is our requirement? We need B intersection C value and A intersection B value. Right? A intersection B value. Directly I will write A intersection B. For these two sets, what are the common elements? 3 which is not common element. 4 also not common element. 5 and 6 are common elements. 5 comma 6. This is our A intersection. After that we need B intersection C. B intersection C is equal to, means common elements in B and C. That is 6 and 8. After that, find the LHS of second problem. LHS. What's our LHS? A intersection of B intersection C. That's equal to. What is our set A? Set A is 3, 4, 5, 6. Intersection as it is. Replace this set. B intersection C. Already we have B intersection C. That is 6 and 8. Now, intersection means common elements in these two sets. What are the common elements? Only one element is in common. That is 6. Take this as equation number 1. After that, look at our edges. Consider our edges. This is our RHS part, that is A intersection B intersection C, that's equal. Replace this end. A, already we have A intersection B value. A intersection B common elements in A and B, that is 5 and 6. Intersection set C, this is our set C, that is 4, 6 and 8. Now in these two terms, what are the common elements? Among these two sets, what are the common elements? That is 6. Take this as base number 2. From 1 and 2, LHS is same as RHS. What is our LHS? A intersection of B intersection C is equal to A intersection B intersection C. Associative property. Just verification. Clearly LHS is same as RHS. This result, these results are true for any sets. These results are true for all the sets. Associative property. Next problem. Then find first one, A intersection B. Second one, A intersection C. Third one, B intersection C. Fourth one, B intersection D. Fifth one, A intersection B intersection C. And sixth one, A intersection B intersection D. Seventh one, B intersection C intersection D. Clearly set A, B, C, D are given. We need to find these values. First one, A intersection B. Directly I will write A intersection, or else you can follow the steps. First write set A, intersection set B, then write the required. Directly I will write A intersection B. What are the common elements in A and B? A intersection B. Common elements in A and B. Clearly C and D. This is our A intersection B. After that, A intersection C, second one. we need to find A intersection B. I will write directly A intersection C also. I will write directly A and C. What are the common elements in A and C? A which is not there in C, B which is not there in C, D. There is no common elements in A and C. There is no common elements in A and C means null set, not zero. Null set. Or simply write this symbol. Clear that these two represents null set. A intersection C. Between A and C, there is no element in common. Up to here D, here after E, F, G, H. So A intersection C is null set. Third one, B intersection C. B intersection C equal. Between B and C, what are the common elements? E and F. This is our B intersection C. After that, fourth one, B intersection D. B intersection D. Just look at B and D. What are the common elements? Again, B intersection D is also null set. Because between B and D, there is no common element. Between B and D, there is no common element means clearly null set. Fifth one, A intersection B intersection C means write common elements in three sets B, A, B, C. Among these three sets, which elements are common? Or else, first write B intersection C. I will write one more step. Simply write B intersection C. I will write A remains as it is. That is A, B, C, D, intersection. Write B intersection C well. Write this. B intersection C. Between these two, what are the common elements? E and F. Between B and C, common elements E and F. After that, what are the common elements in these two sets? There is no common element means clearly null set. A intersection B intersection C is also null set. Next, sixth one. Sixth one, A intersection B intersection D. That's it. This write this part remains as it is. A intersection. Sorry, A write set A as it is. That is A, B, C, D. Intersection. Write B intersection D value. B intersection D. Already we know. Just look at fourth one. Fourth one is B intersection D is null set. Intersection of any set with null set is null set. A intersection null set gives null set. This is one of the non-empty set and is empty set. Intersection of empty and non-empty is equal to empty. If you take intersection of a set with empty set, it gives empty set. This is symbol for empty set. This is also symbol for empty set. So clearly it gives null set. And lastly, seventh one, B intersection C. B intersection C, intersection D. Already we have B intersection C value. You can write this part or B intersection C intersection D. You can first take B intersection C, then take intersection with D, or else take C intersection D, then take intersection with B. That's it. As your convenience, you can take B intersection C, then intersection with D, or else you take C intersection D, then take intersection with B. Here we have B intersection C value. So I will consider this part. What is B intersection C? B intersection C. E comma F. Intersection with D. What is set D? G, H, I and Z. Among these two, there is no common element. Is equal to null set. Are simply these two symbols represents a null set. Thank you.